The Star of the Week。
さて今週のスター of the Week はこの人たちをスタジオにゲストとして迎えております。紹介しましょう。Mr.Mister。Welcome.
Thank you.
How about introducing yourself to the camera?
I'm Richard Page.
I'm Steve George.
I'm Steve Ferris.
I'm Pat Mastelotto.
And I understand you haven't been sleeping good. No jet lag.
Some of us have. I slept pretty good today.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. We came up from Australia, so...
You had concerts there?
Yes, we played two concerts, one in Melbourne and one in Sydney.
Mm-hmm. And, how were the crowd there?
Very good. Very good.
And this is your first visit?
As a band, yes.
As a band.
I think three of us have been to Japan before. Steve is the only one that has been here.
I've never been.
Oh, you were here
as
a part of...
We played with Kitaro one
time. Oh, that's a television that's show. A jingle for...
For a movie or something
for
like that.
For Noodle, right?
No.
No, it has been written.
Really?
Yeah, I think
that's a lie.
I'm not joking.
It's a rumor.
It's a rumor?
Yeah, we played... We did a TV show that was based on a movie called...
An animated movie called Space Queen.
Yeah.
Oh, you did
and
the soundtrack.
And we sang the theme song with Kitaro.
And Darius Sadaka,
Neil Sadaka's daughter. Oh, we have to correct that, because many magazines, you know, you came to Japan first to sing the jingle for the instant noodle.
That's news to me.
Oh?
I never heard about that. But.
Okay. Yeah, but we know you have been around for a long time.
Right, yeah,
eating plenty of noodles, too.
What is it like to be, you know, around for a long time and you know, you came... On top.
Suddenly make it.
Yeah.
They say we made it overnight after 10 years, you know.
Yeah.
You know, that old saying. Steve and I have been working together, writing songs together for about 10 years, and we met up with Steve and Pat about 3 years ago. Yeah. So we've all had a lot of studio experience. We've been studio musicians, and we've written songs and recorded and backed other people and arranged and things like that for years and years. But we always wanted to have our own band and be successful at that. Mm-hmm. And we were fortunate enough to have a couple of number one hits in the States with this album. And so things are going good.
Right. You were together since high school, right?
We met just out of high school.
Oh, just out.
We started playing in bar bands.
You had your own band, right? I mean...
More or less. Rich used to come in and sit in with us every once in a while and ended up joining the club band I was in.
It was an all R&B kind of band. It was dance music, like Stevie Wonder.
Covers.
Yeah, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And that's where we really started learning how to play. And eventually we got tired of that and decided to start writing.
Went up to L.A. and started.
Gradually people started to hear us, and we got a record deal with a band called Pages.
Yeah, yeah.
1979.
That's a famous story now.
I guess
you must have worked with various kinds of musicians. I mean, not only rock and roll, but you know, the fusion or slick music, the basic music.
Right, everything.
A lot of different kinds.
Yeah. What was the experience like?
Well, it's kind of strange. Sometimes we'd be called to do a heavy rock session in the morning, and then that evening would be like an MOR kind of thing, Barry Manilow or something like that. So. It was really diverse. One day we'd be doing something completely different than the next day. But all the time we were learning a lot about the studio and working with guys like Quincy Jones and David Foster and Jay Graydon and people like that and learning a lot.
You stole a lot.
Yeah. Stole a lot of their ideas.
Borrow is the word.
Tell us about your concert. You're going to perform how long?
We're doing
3 hours?
No.
All together, with all six shows.
We're doing three shows in Tokyo.
That'll be 3 hours.
One in Osaka and one in Nagoya. But
just about the same thing you did in Australia.
Yeah, it's the same thing. We have a good time. You know, we try to concentrate on making the sound right. We feel like you rob people if they go to a concert and the sound is harsh or if it doesn't quite stack up to the way the album sounds, you know, because you get used to hearing an album. And when you go see a band, I think you kind of want to have that same sort of sound come at you when you're playing. So we try to specialize in making the sound right and play the best we can and just have a good time, and that rubs off on people.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for dropping by.